Welcome back, listeners. I'm Robin Black, and this is It's All About Healing podcast. Today, we have a special guest with us, Ms. Jen Aul. She is going to tell us how to become the best version of yourself because she is the founder of Style Consult. So, Jen, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Hello, I'm Jen Aul. I'm the founder of Style Consult and Style. So, thanks for having me today. I'm a media consultant with experience of 20 years experience in beauty and fashion. So I help people look good, feel good, so they can achieve their goals.
I like that. So you actually help people in healing just by making them feel better about themselves. Is that correct?
100%. When you look good, you feel confident about yourself, and there's just nothing stops you from there.
All right. And what had you start this consult?
So my job was the web design. I was specializing in beauty and fashion e-commerce, so designing the website. Then I learned that how I make the product look better, it also applies to the people too. So mm-hmm. as you, like my friends, you know that like I work for the beauty and fashion, so they came to me for advice on how they can actually look better for their interview or the important meetings or even a date. So I start helping them, and the people can see that my friends are thriving. They get promotion and they start their own business and they get in the relationship. So people are reaching me out like, I don't know why you did it for your friends, but then can you do the same thing for me? That's how y'all got started. So I help people look better so they feel more confident in themselves so they can reach their goal. Then it was literally after work, because I had a full-time job and a weekend, I set my living room. So they people come in, you know, we talk, I make them look better. So that's how we got started.
I like that. And did you ever struggle with any of that yourself when you were younger?
Fortunately, that my mom showed me that the looking good is everything, actually, because my mom was also a businesswoman. So she showed me that like looking good and then to put yourself the best out there is the first thing that you need to do. So I learned at very like a young age that how I put myself together.
Okay. And tell us a little bit more about how to contact you and how you help your clients when they go to your website. What clients are looking for?
So mostly that we help entrepreneurs and executives. So because they are the face over their company or the face over their brand. So we help them to showing their best side of them. So they can reach me out, styleconsult.com or my personal website, jeno.com.
Okay. And what would you say is the best way for them to get started?
So once they reach out to me, we do initial consultation. So mm-hmm. we know that what step that they should take. Because it's a one-on-one, it's 100% tailored in the personalized consultation. So everyone's different. Everyone have a different goal. Then we know that what is actually their strength and then which area they should focus. Because it's not like we're not changing them. That's not how it works. We actually learn what side of their personality or their aspect will be the best for them to show to the world. Because we all have a multiple side of us. We mm-hmm. only our personality is like a multiple layers. So you learn that what is your strength, and so you can actually show in your strength to the world.
Okay, I got you. So for anyone who is struggling with their, I don't know, I would say maybe advertisement, they come to you. So then that way you can kind of help them all in all. You get to know them. You have consultations with them, and then you go over their product and websites as well?
100%. So what we do, so when the people come, then we ask, the first question we ask them why they're here. Mm-hmm. If we know why, it's very easy to figure out what we need to do and how we can achieve the goal. So we deep dive into the why. Then mm-hmm. while we're doing the process also, they learn about themselves as well. So why they're there. Because they know that, like, okay, this is what I want to do, but sometimes that they're really focusing on what, and they're really not understanding why they want to do it. So we learn that from like why they want to do it, because why doesn't change? That's your mission, that's the end goal. So understanding why, there's a multiple million different ways that you can reach what. So I always tell people that focus on the goal, but then be flexible for your method, because there are just so many different ways to do it. But that we focus on starting from once we figure out why, then we focus on the outside in method, because it's seeing is believing. I 100% believe in perception is reality. We make sure that when people come to me, they leave with that great first impression. And as soon as they walk out the door, they are making better first impression after meeting with me. That's the one focus of make every impression count.
And how do I love how you said you focus on the why, like understanding the why. And how do you get them to that point for them to actually know the why? Because a lot of people say that this is what I want. And when you ask them why, even like in a job interview, you don't, sometimes they don't really know why. So how do you help them get to that answer?
So it's more about self-discovery, because when they coming in, because they know that, okay, for instance, they want to be C-suite, for instance, they want to be CEO, then we asking them why CEO, why it's going to change your life, how it's going to be actually impact your life. Then they go back and okay, what they actually want to do, why they really craving for being in the C-suite. It could be power, it could be money, or it could be more time to spend because now they're more can make more income. So it's not the title they're looking for, but they what they are actually achieving with a title. So we are focusing on why they want to be in a C-suite. Because many different ways, they don't have to be C-suite as long as they're achieving the why they want to do it.
I just love that because I even think that I have struggled with that so many times in so many different areas, finding the why. That is just, I think that's a gift on its own, is to be able to help someone find or to locate their why they're doing something. So if someone were to say, "Hey, I want to be a firefighter," and they're like, "Why?" And then they just go, "I don't know." Like, how do you, it's like, how do you help them do that? Just, I like saving lives. And then you amplify their, whatever it is that they're bringing to you, however they want to present themselves, you would just amplify them saving lives, right?
And then they also it's more like the what how you feel about yourself too, because right deep down that it's all about yourself, it's you. But it's you starting it, you are achieving this, and then they are you are going to make something out of it. So it's really we actually know why, but then the thing is that we just do not really pinpoint why we're doing it. So understanding that, because our image, because I'm image consultant also do the personal branding, but our image actually involves as life involves. So it's static. There's no one image that works for all. So way that you understanding why, actually your angle, because eventually you are getting there. You're not going to be like a turn it off and turn it on like as you need it, but then it gradually evolving to be where you want to be. So your why is kind of your North Star.
I like that. I love that. Okay, that makes a lot of sense. Your why is your North Star. And then so you actually really help with a lot of self-discovery. How often do you have clients that come to you and then they say, "Hey, this is what I want," but then they expand it even greater just by having this consultation with you and being, and how long exactly do you work with each client, or does that differ?
It's different per clients. Also, that in my thing that I have a very like a long-term relationship, and then I check with them and then where they are in their life stage because your life involves. So, for instance, this client came in that he's a very successful person, but then they also he wears all these major brand but then it really doesn't show his personality and who he was. Mm-hmm. So he mentioned that he actually came in wearing this hat, and then it was a limited edition, very exclusive, and only few people have it. So he was very proud of, like, oh, I got this. So he mentioned that, oh yeah, everyone there like really complimenting of hat. So like, I asked him that. So are they like, did they actually say about your hat, or did they say something that you look good with the hat?
Mm-hmm.
And he realized that nobody actually saying about how good he looked with the hat. They're all complimenting his hat.
Mm-hmm.
So it wasn't about him. It's about like the things that he has. Mm-hmm. So he kind of realized, okay, it's not, because he already felt that somebody complimenting what he had, it's mm-hmm. about him, but it was not. He had nothing to do with himself. Mm-hmm. So now that he, so now he actually have a better style, better image, actually reflecting who he is now, mm-hmm. better hiding behind all these flashy and things, that exclusive items. So he feels more true to himself.
So you helped him become him, right? It just kind of amplifies who they are. Yeah. And I like that. I like that a lot. So do you have, do you do like website designs and things of that nature as well?
So we provide a complete, a comprehensive service of building personal branding. Because mm-hmm. you know, when you do the personal branding, we start from the outside, obviously. Okay. So that you look, how you feel about yourself. And then we also reflect that to your presence on social media, on the online, also the offline as well. So that the, for instance, one of my clients had a very important meeting with mm-hmm. his partner, and he asked me that, okay, so how I should wear something. So I recommending that the wardrobe that he should wear. Also, he had another podcast guest. So mm-hmm. then we talked about like how he should present himself and how he gonna position. And then we also go over the questions, and then the a biography, so that they also eat, reflecting who he really is and what kind of message he want to portray. Then we have like an event, then he knows that how to react with this perspective, or the, how he can actually showing that what kind of business who he is as well.
Okay, so the consultation is about the person specifically, and mm-hmm. what they should do to kind of amplify their brand and amplify themselves.
Mm-hmm.
So do you also tell them, like, do you help them say, hey, these are what you should do as far as social media. Once mm-hmm. you come here, then you should, you know, open up TikTok, open up Instagram. Do you help them along that way as well? Or is it only individually?
So we the style consult to help is that holistic approach. Mm-hmm. So we identify the which area they should focus, because okay. Everyone is different. Some they just need a YouTube, or some they need to. So we focus on one channel for the social mm-hmm. media. But once you have one channel, it's easy to expand. Rather okay. than you go all different channel and doing it once. So we identify which one they should focus on first. Then we expand.
Okay. I love that. So walk us through the process of just coming on your website and say, hey, I want to go ahead and book this consultation. Mm-hmm. What's the process after that?
So then we reach out, and then we do one call. Then we talk about the whole process. And then it's okay to look at, because we always make the session as the complete session. Because we want to make sure that when people coming in, there is something that they have to do another one to get going. So as soon as they're coming in, they know what they need to do.
Mm-hmm.
When they come in, either they can go ahead and do the stuff, or that we can extend the multiple sessions. So it's always important that they leave with actionable things, and they feel better that they are already making progress.
Okay, I like that. Oh my goodness, this is so exciting. So Do you do online consultations as well, or do you do in-person both?
Oh, we do only online consultation.
Okay, only. Okay.
Yes, because that helps people all over the world, regardless of where they are.
Okay, gotcha. I completely understand now. So, is there anything that maybe I didn't go over that you want to include?
So I love to help people to succeed because I truly believe that how you perceived by others really impacted the outcome that you want to achieve. So look good, that's the first part. And feel confident, that's the second. Then the possibility is endless. So make every first impression count because there's no second chance to make a first impression. So that be in control. You can control how others perceive you by your look. So that.
Okay, I like that. So basically, body positivity and just being comfortable in your own skin and knowing who you are.
100%. So once you start working with us, you will know that you are actually already doing the stuff that you're supposed to do. You just need to tweak a few things. Then you will be very surprised at how attractive you look. Because I love to see like people smile that they see him themselves. They're like, yeah, I look good today.
And then what would you suggest for the ones who just are maybe battling depression and they just don't feel like themselves? They don't feel very well. And how do they kind of, when you're not feeling well, still try to put yourself together?
Right. So each, that's what I really vocalize about seeing is believing. Because it's sometimes it's not easy to get out of it. Or you want to put something on, it's challenging. I've been there, literally. I've been there, done that. So I always tell people that the first step to be going to gym is actually getting out of bed. It's not going to the gym. You need to getting out of bed. That's the first step. So I always tell people that, okay, so if you have a hard time getting stuff done, I tell them to go brush your teeth. Because when you go brush your teeth, then you're actually waking up. You are doing something. I want them to get in the motion. Once you're getting the motion, you brush your teeth, you feel like, okay, I'm starting my day. That's the first thing people do. Brush your teeth and starting your day. So getting the motion, I always, if you don't want to brush your teeth, fine. Go take like a cup of water, drink the water. So you, at least you feel hydrating. So always tell people that do the small things. It doesn't have to be put on your dress. It could be just to go brush your teeth or get a cup of water. Get yourself in motion. Once you're in a motion, it actually trigger you to moving forward. What you need to do.
I like that. Thank you so much. Thank you again so much. It's been a pleasure having you on the show, and I greatly appreciate your time.
Thank you so much for having me today.
No problem. And please tell the listeners again, what's the name of your website?
So my website is styleconsole.com, it with a K. And then also you can visit my personal website, jenauh.com, JenauH.com.
All right. Thank you so much. And again, that's going to be in the show notes as well. It's going to be listed below. And again, this is Robin Black, and this is It's All About Healing podcast. Everyone, stay blessed.